Yeah.
He's sick?
No, I just take him to, fight off shit. You know,
oh, you do, just in case.
Well, because I can't get to sleep till 2 in the morning with all the depressing thoughts and everything come back because I'm not drinking right now, you know. So that's usually how I handle being on the road, you know.
Yeah.
You know, not being able to go home. My family's not there. What I do, Jimmy, is I go out and I get just right to the point of passing out so I can walk in my apartment, not realize there's no one else there and just face plant into the bed. Then wake up the next day and be like, oh, God, why did I do that?
Yeah.
Stupid.
But you try to skip those feelings.
Why did I stop? Just because I'm going to shoot a special, I know, in the next few months, and I don't want to be that fucking guy who tries to dry out in 10 days.
Oh, right.
And then you have that. That's even a worse look. You're better to just keep boozing at that point. So you're like, yeah, he's living the life, as opposed to having this weird sort of beginning of rehab. Yeah, you know, I don't know. I've just been reading up more on health stuff. I got a kid now, so I kind of have to. Every once in a while, I just sort of tap out for a good, you know, 1 month to 6 months to a year or something like that. So I was watching this great thing last night. What kind of drinker are you? And I was watching this English guy, and you know, the way they drink is, you know, the doctors have the same thing, the amount you're supposed to drink in a week. And he's like doing, like, he has the app and shit like that. He's like, all right, I drink twice this in a night, you know? And just the way he was like, he had that same thing that I have where it's like, I'm not an alcoholic, but if you put it on paper, it's just like, well, then what are you?
Yeah.
You're not a fucking.
How many out of 20 did you answer yes to? Because they have that whole, there's a test you can take. Are you an alcoholic? 20 questions. So have you ever taken that test?
No, but it's also like, I just, when I stop, it sucks for 3 days. And after 4 days, it's like, I could really just never do this again.
Right.
So I don't like wake up with shakes like, I need it,
right,
man.
Right. Yeah.
You know, start lashing out at people.
And you're not missing.
I said, close the door. I'm not like that fucking guy.
And you're not missing out on stuff.
No, but I definitely got to a point where I wasn't able to just have one socially. Like,
right.
I was just like, all right, we're doing this.
Did you see the ESPN? Did you see the 30 for 30 Ric Flair movie they did?
Yeah, I did. It was amazing.
It was amazing.
I felt it should have been at least 6 hours long, but I liked that his was still like 2 hours long or something like
that. It was. But they started going through his drinking stories, and it was clearly alcoholism to the point that he was in the hospital like a year ago, and they're like, you have to stop drinking. But there was no sort of violins or anything. It was just funny that he went to the doctor and he was like, yeah, I drink 15 drinks a day.
But is that him lying, though, and just overstating what he does because he's
no.
Ric Flair?
I mean, there's many witnesses to all of his activities. Okay. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, 15 drinks a day. And the doctor's like, how often? And he's like, well, every day for the last 30 years. And it's just, it just doesn't
affect him. My favorite thing, just being a comedian, because he's the best guy ever to do the interviews, like, it's not even close. I mean, The Rock was amazing, but like he's the best ever. And someone said, "Did you have writers? Did you work in blah blah blah?" And he goes, he just laughed. He goes, "Writers." He goes, "I used to come up with half of that shit on the car ride over from the airport." And it was just like, you know, that's like high level performance where you just come up. Oh, I'm going to talk about that, and you just go out there, and you could feel the crowd,
yeah,
and adjust to their. Energy and all that. I mean, he's a lunatic.
There's nothing great better than a shit promo. Like, bad wrestling promos are incredible to watch.
I would have loved, though, to have been, like, driving past Ric Flair and just see him kind of half-mumbling his promos to himself as he was trying to figure him out. Just kind of half-getting into Ric Flair mode as he's driving. Like,
the thing about that guy is when you listen to him, like, he loved being it.
Oh, my God.
And then he loved the fans being interested in him. He loves being Ric Flair. He loves doing that. And, I actually went to the premiere of that 30 for 30. I had an acting gig in Atlanta, and the guy who directed it, and I got to go to it. Dude, and the stories he was telling, like, and he's just so open. They go, how faithful were you? How long were you faithful to your first wife? And he just goes, oh. he goes, like 3 days.
Yeah.
And she was there. And he was just going like, he was just so honest. He was home with his wife and kid. He goes, I was just bored. Like the social pressure to be like, you know, and then I got a whole new perspective. Yeah. I understood. He could just sit there and be like, nah, I was bored.
Right.
I had the Hallmark life and I was bored. And it was just like, he was meant to be out there. in front of people, and for some reason, I don't know. I guess it's looked. I guess when you hurt other people, that's a bad thing. But I mean, it's looked down on that. No, he's a fucking rock star.
He wasn't worried about missing birthdays and doing all this other stuff. He was like, "There's so much fun out here. I don't know why you would want me to be at home at this kid's birthday party, even if it is my kid."
At what point?
I don't think he's that bad, but it definitely the whole monogamy thing was not his thing.
At what point is the ex-wife okay with that? Like, just to go out there with him and now go, "Yeah, divorced, he fucked other people. Like, yeah, it's whatever. It's cute."
I think when the 9 millionth person just goes like, "Dude, you married Ric Flair. Like, what?
What did you think was going to happen?
Where could this have gone?"
He had platinum blonde hair down to his shoulders, walking around with hooker boots and tights on. I mean, what did you think this guy was going to do?
Yeah, they
go to the farmer's market.
They showed him like cutting these promos, and he would go like in front of the audience, and he would announce his. He'd point to girls in the audience and on television announce his hotel and the hotel room. And his wife would be like, "Rick, why are you doing that?" And he's like, "Honey, it's all the character." And she's like, "Yeah, but that's your actual hotel room. Like, you didn't have to actually put the hotel room out there."
Would they ever show up?
Yeah. Yeah, they would.
I don't know.
The invite was real.
Let's not put him on blast here.
It's in the doc.
Oh,
I mean, you know, it's all in the 30 for 30, so.
He's old now, right? Was he fucking 65, 70 years old?
Yeah. Yeah, I think he's in his 70s.
I'm sure he doesn't care.
No, he doesn't care. He loves these stories.
Yeah. Old guys don't care anymore.
No. No, he's 69. I mean, these are his medals of honor.
Is there anything wrong with him, or is he kind of holding up all right?
He's okay now. I mean, he was bad for a little bit. He was in the hospital.
For what?
I can't remember if his heart gave out, but they thought he was going to die for a while.
That's right.
But now he's back to just
like his wrestling match. You thought he was going to lose, and all of a sudden he came back. It's all performance with this guy.
He kicked out at two, and now he's backstage at the shows again. Like, he's just... He's back to being Ric Flair. I don't think he drinks as much.
Well, it's the internet is what, you know, because he, you know, back when I was growing up, there was territory. So I was in the WWF territory, and he never really wrestled for Vince until later in his career. So I missed all of that. So I, you know, when I discovered him on YouTube, and just it was one of the great YouTube rabbit holes that ever went down. Like, I think I woke my wife up. I was crying, just crying, laughing. That first time I saw that, my shoes cost more than your house.
I mean,
and the guy he was talking to, you could just tell it was true. And it's just such a funny...
He's picking up his shoe. He's got it in his hand, and he's shaking it at him. My shoes cost more than your house.
And just to sit there and, like, just brag of the privilege that you were born... I was born with a golden spoon in my mouth, just saying I never had to work or anything, and then just saying, like, Voss, you know, Voss goes, "It's Donna Karen." Yeah. And he pulls out the label. I mean, he has elements of Ric Flair.
Have you seen his rings?
Oh.
Voss's hand rings?
Yeah, I just love...
Have you seen them?
I just love how Rich is one of those guys, no matter how classy you dress him, he still looks like a dirtbag. Yeah. That's why I love him.
Because he's ugly inside, you got...
You think that's what it is?
Yeah. Yeah, those are Voss's...
I think
that's
Voss's
hand.
There might be a little bit of Photoshop.
There's no way
there.
You can do that, and you have to play piano if you're going to be wearing those types... What is he, fucking Fats Domino?
There he is.
Oh my God.